Before making this video, I watched lots of Philips Hue installation videos, and the one thing missing from them was there wasn't actually very much installation in them. Lots of unboxing, lots of technical setup, but in this video, we're going to show you how to turn this rather dull room into this, or this, or this, or this. That's Rick by the fire, by the way. This is the concentration scene. But before we get to the fancy stuff, let's remind ourselves about the Hue product. It started out as the original smart lighting system, as a colour-changing lamp you could retrofit to your existing installation. But since then, the range has grown enormously, and we think it's certainly worth another look, particularly for electricians who may get asked to install it by the clients, but also for first fix installation. So stick around, because we've got some top tips on how you can save money in any installation using this Hue system, which now includes everything from the lamps itself, traditional filament lamps, fixtures, and our always popular lead tape. Now, when it comes to wireless lighting control, there is one major advantage, and ironically, it is the wires. All of the fixtures that we've installed here are wired on one lighting circuit that's simply looped between the different fixtures. Now, this might not sound groundbreaking, but think of a traditional lighting installation when you want to control a group of fixtures or an individual lamp that has to be wired individually back to its own switch, or if you want to add dimming, you have to add a dimmer to that panel as well. So you end up with rows of switches, probably not very well labeled, that people don't remember what they do, and that's all unnecessary expense when you move to this system. Now let's just unpack that a little bit more with these pendants behind us. Now I know what you're thinking, yes, we've spent years trying to hide filament lamps, but now we celebrate them in their LED form, and this smart example from the Hue range is part of that. Now we've built these decorative pendants with some eFIXX themed red and black flexible cable and these rather nice brass lamp holders. But the important bit is, imagine that customer. Now customers, I'm not saying they change their mind, but they may not know exactly what they want at the start of a project. So naturally you'd think all of these pendants would be controlled together. They are all certainly wired together. But with the Hue system, if I wanted to make some changes, I could switch each one individually, or I could even bring in some of the really smart features and get them to flicker like a candle. And that level of controllability extends to all of the fixtures in the Hue range. Now the Centris fixture above me has a linear panel in the middle and three spotlights. Each individual element can be controlled for its white light output and also those dynamic color change features. So I might want to add a red hue to the room using the linear element of the fixture, but then highlight some things on the wall with some white spotlights, or perhaps go back into Tokyo mode and just go completely dynamic. We've also added this Hubris pendant so we get some nice white light on the table when we want it, but we can also use the uplight element of this fixture to match the cove lighting that we've installed behind us. Hopefully we've shown that wireless control is great for new projects to simplify the wiring. It can also be really useful when it comes to refurbishment programs as well. Imagine you've got an installation where the switching positions are all over the place. Perhaps the lights are controlled on different circuits. Well, that's another advantage of wireless control, because what you can do is bring them all together into one central location and obviously add that app in that we'll come to in another video. What we've also done here as well is managed to integrate some existing lighting that we already had into our control scheme. So we've brought in the neon sign behind us and some existing shelf lighting using the smart plugs that are also part of the Hue system. Further demonstrate the flexibility of the system, we've used this Philips wall switch module to create what I believe is the world's biggest wireless switch. Now I'm not suggesting your home light switches look like this, but if you want to repurpose an existing light switch and make them part of the Hue system, this product is the one for you. Perhaps your switch matches your decor and you don't want to change them, and it also prevents that other problem of the switch itself disconnecting the power to the smart lights. The electrical installation for the Hue pendants is incredibly simple. It's just like any other domestic light fitting that you would install. You just need to bring a line, neutral, and a protective conductor to them. Bags of wiring room in there. These are designed to go up against a flat ceiling, so you'd have typically a plasterboard above there. We've made some modifications to work with our open plan ceiling and the cable basket that we've installed here. I'll leave a link in the description and in the eye above my head that shows you how we went through our installation process and conversion to make that happen. I'll also leave a link for the video that showed you how we made our filament pendants as well. But perhaps you're going to leave all of the controls to the customer so they can set up their desired scene. The good news about these products is they all come out of the box pre-programmed to operate in this warm white color as soon as you power them up, so you don't need to do any programming to leave the job with everything looking the same. If you're using the Hue product as part of a complete lighting installation, it's probably the white that's going to be the most important element of it, because that's still what we like to work under most of the time. And this Hue product really delivers there in the terms of the quality of the white light it produces. A lot of RGB systems may have a white channel tacked on there, but really I'm impressed with the depth you can go from between the warm and the cool white with this system. And we can see that in this LED strip here with the RGB chip and the dedicated channels for cool and warm white. So five channels of control. And again, that's mirrored across all of the products in this range. One of the main features in our lighting scheme here are these cove features here that we've formed out of timber at the top and the bottom of the walls, just to give a wash of light up the wall and across onto the ceiling or down onto the floor. When you're looking at features like this, we always recommend that you do some trials, a little bit of a mock-up to check that you're going to get the desired lighting effect, because after all, it's something a lot of work goes into building it. You wouldn't want it to be in the wrong place. Then when it comes to actually placing the LED strip within the cove, there's a few options there as well. We've gone and fixed it straight down onto the surface here so we get maximum wash up the wall and across the ceiling. That makes installation a little bit more complex because we have to cut and turn the corners because you can't bend the strip in this direction. An easier option would have been just to stick the strip to the back of the wall section there or onto the front upstand. But we found that didn't quite give us enough light distribution up the wall, so that's why we went for that option. Core features like this are a great solution for rooms where possibly the ceiling height is lower and you want to increase the apparent height of a room. A lot of time people rush for downlights, and you know, downlights don't put any light on the ceiling and very little light on the walls, but by, and they almost mean like you're gonna crouch when you go into a room, they really effectively bring that ceiling, it makes it look like it's a lower ceiling. By doing this with a cove lighting feature, it's a great way to light a room. I don't really like spending my life upside down on a dusty floor trying to install LED strip into this feature. Some top tips from us on how to make your life incredibly easy is, instead of trying to do those connections under here and the sticking the tape from the LED strip to the feature itself, is do as much as possible on the bench. So for us, that means putting it onto an aluminium profile so that we bring it in fully tested, so we just have to put in the final screws and make the final connection. In this project as well, what we've also done is put some clear adhesive lined heat shrink at the end of the profiles, because that's where they tend to peel away. So just add some extra resilience to the LED strip before installation. We've also used the Lightstrip Plus to create a glow around this TV screen. We used a similar assembly approach. We assembled everything on the bench, carefully marking our cut points and our bend positions so that we can assemble it and just bring it already pre-assembled on the LED profile and drop it onto the timber frame that we built behind us. We've used the standard version. There is another version that plugs into your HDMI port on the television so you can match the colors around the screen to what's happening on the screen. And to do that, you'll need to add one of these Hue sync boxes. Another top tip when it comes to creating the kind of cove section we've installed here, you will notice that the depth of the channel we've created is much bigger than the actual strip itself. This allows us to create room for the light inside there to diffuse, so you can't see the spots from any individual LED, and also allows us to mask any shadows that might occur where we've created joins in the LED strip itself. Those dimensions as well also allow us to include the small driver that comes with each of the Lightstrip Plus kits. The kit comes with the driver and 2 meters of strip, of which you can then extend in 1 meter intervals up to a maximum of 10 meters. So we've used three driver sections here, or three LED Strip Plus kits, one for the strip at the top of the wall, one for the cove section at the bottom, and another one for around the TV, so we can then control each one of those independently and have different colours and effects on each part of the set. Now, at this stage, you're probably thinking, this doesn't look like an ordinary room, and regular viewers to the channel will, of course, recognise it as our set that we use for our regular YouTube live streams. And one of the reasons behind using this Hue system is we're really looking forward to harnessing the dynamic features where you too can also interact with the lighting system. But the techniques we've shown here can be applied in almost any type of installation. And we traditionally think of the Hue product as suitable for residential and where we started from, those retrofit applications. But having done this installation here, I can think of loads of applications that probably electricians deal with on a daily basis. So I'm thinking small retail shops or restaurants where you could use it as the main lighting, but think of what you can do at different times of the year to go to those flagpole events. So Halloween, Valentine's Day, Christmas, certain changing colors with seasons, all can be incorporated into a lighting scheme. And with that single power supply that goes around all the fixtures, it means the actual setup in terms of fixed wiring is really simple. And when it comes to control, people still prefer the trusty light switch by the door that you could just flick on and the lights come on as you'd expect. You don't want to be grappling around in the dark to open up an app or when you've got your hands full of plates and cups. And as part of the Hue system, we've installed this smart dimmer switch, which offers a lot of functionality beyond just a switch, and it can be a switch, but it's also a remote control because, of course, as you'd expect, it is wireless and battery powered as well. So I can switch the lights off and back on again. I can dim them up and down, and I can also trigger the scenes that we've programmed as part of the setup just by pushing the Hue button at the bottom. Now, all of this is fully customizable within the app, and that's what we're going to look at in our next video, how we set this system up and how you can integrate with other control systems beyond the light switch. Yes, it is important, but you can also bring in things like voice assistants and even tie it to other things happening in the room and other smart systems.